On this very first episode of Keeping Up with the Krishnamurthys, I'll be sharing all about our adventurous RV trip and answer all the questions that I got about this trip on Instagram. If you're already following me on IG, then you got a sneak peek of this trip. And if you're not, make sure that you do so that you don't miss out on all of the helpful tips I'm constantly sharing over there. Hey guys, if you're new here, I'm Vishali, and it's been forever since I've created a YouTube video, but it's just been absolute insanity. We recently did a major home renovation, then we moved, had a baby, and on top of it all, I had to start homeschooling my other kids during my maternity leave since school's closed and they're still young and have a hard time sitting in front of a computer all day long. Anyway, I'm glad that all of that is behind us, at least for now. Who knows, by the time I publish this video, we might be back to virtual school, and if that's the case, I'll probably post a new video a year from now. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so that you'll be notified when that video is posted. All right, enough about me and my drama, let's get into today's video. So I have four kids, and at the beginning of the summer, we met up with a friend at the park. He has three kids, and he was telling us all about this amazing RV trip that he went on with his family. They went for 6 weeks and had already booked their second RV trip. My husband, Kieran, and I figured if they could do it for 6 weeks, we could easily do 1 week in an RV. Boy, were we wrong. Easy is definitely not the word I'd use to describe an RV trip. It's not easy, but it is a memorable experience, and today I'll share how you can prepare for a trip like this to make it as easy as possible. The first thing we did was decide where we wanted to go in this RV. Since it was our first time, we didn't want to go far away, so we chose campgrounds that were 2 to 3 hours away max. We then did a quick search using the Campgrounds of America website to make sure they had availability for us to park the RV there. We were planning this trip about a month before we wanted to go on it, and people usually book RV sites months in advance, so we had to make sure we could get spots before booking the RV. Once we saw there was availability where we wanted to go, we then booked the RV. We just went with our friend's recommendation and booked the RV through Canna Dream. We went with the second largest RV that they had since we have a fairly big family. We don't have any complaints, it was all good, but you might want to do your research and see what else is out there before you book. If you happen to find an awesome RV rental company, please let me know in the comments because I'm pretty sure we'll do a trip like this again. As for the cost of the RV rental, I'll break down the cost of this trip later in this video. Once the RV was booked, we immediately went back on the Campgrounds of America website and booked our sites. The last thing you want is to have an RV and nowhere to park it. Apparently, you can park overnight at a Walmart if necessary. But who wants to spend the night in a Walmart parking lot? You also won't have access to water, electricity, and sewage, so make sure to book your campsites right away. Once that was all done, we simply told the kids about the trip and used it as leverage all summer. Anytime they misbehaved, we threatened them and told them that we'd cancel the trip or that we'd leave them at Grandma and Grandpa's and go on our own. Speaking of Grandma and Grandpa, we decided to leave baby Lara there for the week because an RV and campsites isn't exactly baby friendly. So it would just be Kieran and I and my 2, 4, and 6-year-old, Josh, Kian, and Isha. A few weeks before the trip, I started to think about what we need and purchase things like a portable barbecue and propane and some firewood. We already had everything else we'd need on a trip like this at home, so there wasn't any need to buy a bunch of stuff. Then a week before the trip, I went online and found a bunch of camping recipes. I printed them out because I didn't know what the internet situation would be like on this trip, so I wanted to make sure I had a hard copy of the recipes with me. Turns out all the sites had internet access, but better safe than sorry. I then made a list of all the ingredients we'd need to make these meals, and the day before the trip, I picked up the groceries. The mistake that I made was I bought way too much. First off, I planned too many meals, and even though I left a lot of blank spots on my meal plan, I still planned too many meals. We were often out and about and didn't get a chance to make everything. I was also worried that the RV would be hard to drive and park, and I didn't know if we'd be able to stop at a Walmart along the way, so I brought all the groceries for the entire week. When we were on the trip, we realized it was actually pretty easy to stop at a Walmart. So if I were to do this again, I'd only bring enough food for a couple days and then buy groceries during the trip if and when we needed them. The problem with bringing too much is that the fridge isn't very big, so you'll run out of space in there. You'll also take up a lot of space in the RV with pantry items. We had to bring a cooler and keep buying ice to keep items that didn't fit in the fridge cold. So my suggestion would be not to bring too much food. I really wanted to try all of these unique recipes and I'm glad I did. We made so many delicious things like skillet beer cheese, campfire berry peach cobbler, campfire caprese brie, egg bake breakfast foil packets, chicken fajitas, pizza and garlic bread, cheesy campfire potatoes, and grilled shrimp fire packs. I've saved all of these recipes in my RV trip highlight on Instagram, so check that out if you want those recipe links. But you can also keep it super simple. Cereal for breakfast, burgers and hot dogs for lunch and dinner, and granola bars for snacks. There's no need to go crazy with the food unless that's something you're looking forward to, which in our case, we were. As for cooking tools, dishes, etc., we just paid for the kitchen kit that they offer. That way, you don't have to bring any of your own stuff. We still brought a knife, barbecue tool set, bottle opener, my large cutting board, my cast iron skillet, and a couple dishcloths. We also brought an espresso machine because that's an absolute must-have for us. You'll have to look at what's on the RV and then decide if you're missing any cooking tools or utensils if you do decide to go with a kitchen kit. If I were to do it again, I'd still get the kitchen kit because otherwise you're gonna have to pack a lot more stuff. It comes pretty well equipped, but just double check to make sure you have everything you need. Now that all the food was figured out, it was time to pack. I started the day before leaving. I packed all of the kids' stuff and my own stuff. My husband packed his own stuff. I like to use packing cubes to keep everything organized. I'll link them in the description box down below. Every member of the family has a different color, and when I pack the kids' clothes, I plan out the outfits, roll it up, and then put it in the packing cube. I kept it simple with their clothes, shorts, t-shirts, underwear, a couple jogging suits each for cooler nights, PJs, and swimwear. I also brought some beach towels, bath towels, hand towels, and toiletries. You have to use RV toilet paper, which is one-ply toilet paper. You can order it from the RV company or buy it from stores like Walmart or Canadian Tire. Finally, it was the day of the trip. Kieran removed all of our car seats from our SUV and drove down to the RV pickup location on his own. We had already dropped baby Lara to my parents' house the night before. While he went to pick up the RV, I finished up the packing and took the kids to the library to pick up some DVDs. I highly recommend getting some DVDs for a trip like this. We don't own any, so that's why we went to the library, but these were a lifesaver while driving and when it rained during our trip. We also did movie time one day, made some popcorn on the campfire, snuggled into bed together, and watched Diary of a Wimpy Kid. Anyway, when we got home from the library, Kieran had already arrived with the RV. The kids' reaction was priceless and made all of the planning totally worth it. We then had to start loading up the RV. This was a lot of work. As Kieran was bringing me the stuff, I was putting it directly into the fridge and cabinets. There's compartments at the bottom of the RV for larger items like the barbecue, wood, water, toys for the kids, etc. The car seats for our kids had to be installed on the benches around the dining table. Once everything was loaded, I then got all of the bedding and made the beds. They do offer a bedding kit, but I just wanted to use our own. And I didn't want us to have to sleep in sleeping bags all week, so I used bed sheets, duvets, and pillows. This made sleeping in the RV much more comfortable, but there was a ton of laundry to do when we got back. So keep that in mind if you do decide to bring your own bedding. Finally, it was time to head to our first campsite. I didn't drive the RV, but I'm sure I could if I wanted to. Kieran said it was very similar to driving a U-Haul moving truck. The turns are very wide, you don't want to drive fast, and make sure you're maintaining distance from other vehicles and brake well in advance. Overall, he didn't find it difficult to drive and quickly got comfortable with it. Our first stop was Parry Sound for 2 nights, followed by Sturgeon Falls for 2 nights. We then went to Barrie for 1 night and ended off our trip in Owen Sound for 2 nights. Some of the activities that we did while on the trip included swimming at the pool, going to lakes and beaches. We cooked a ton of food and even the kids helped me make pizza in the cast iron skillet. I cooked so many things in the skillet, I'll link it down below. We learned a bunch of new recipes that I will be adding to my meal planning system. I have an entire system that helps me plan, prep, and cook all of the meals for my entire family. If you want to know more, make sure to check out my Clear the Clutter membership. I've linked it in the description box down below. In this membership, I teach people how to fully declutter and organize their homes step by step. We also create personalized cleaning guides, a weekly cleaning schedule, a home maintenance schedule. We then get into meal planning, and I'll teach you my entire system that makes it easy for me to feed my family of 6 healthy and delicious meals. Anyway, check out the Clear the Clutter membership. It's linked down below if that sounds like something you'd be interested in. Back to the activities. I also brought some paper, crayons, scissors, and glue sticks. I am a teacher, so I know that kids love this kind of stuff. The kids drew a bunch of pictures, made little books, found leaves outside, and created some nature artwork. Though we have a ton of playgrounds at home, all of the campsites had playgrounds and we spent quite a bit of time there since we have young children. Kieran and I would bring a couple chairs, some beers, and just relax while the kids played for hours. Sometimes I'd go back to the RV and prep dinner while Kieran watched the kids at the playground. It really was a great time pass. If you have older children, you can go on hikes or bring their bikes and go bike riding. There's lots to keep them busy. I also picked up some toys from the dollar store that the kids could play with at our campsite. They also found ways to keep themselves busy by simply playing with rocks, sticks, and looking for bugs. The best part was that we didn't take any devices with us and they couldn't ask us for an iPad. In fact, it seemed like they completely forgot about their iPads and didn't even care for them. We even noticed that when we returned home, they were playing with one another more, they wanted to go outside, play with their toys, make things, and weren't constantly asking us if they could have their iPads. Now let's get into the bathroom situation on the RV. There is a shower on it, however you'll want to keep your showers short. Otherwise, you'll have to continue emptying the tank and refilling it with clean water. As for the toilet, it works well and is similar to the toilets that you find on airplanes. The worst part about RVing is emptying the sewage tanks, but to be honest, it's not as bad as we thought it would be. You simply connect the sewage hose to a sewage drainage hole and pull a lever, then everything just flushes out. There's 2 different tanks and you have to do it for each one. They have videos, manuals, and even offer in-person training on how to operate the RV, so you'll quickly and easily learn all of this. Something we learned during this trip is that you should always try to choose campsites that have sewage, water, and electricity on the individual sites. One of the campsites we stayed at was great. It had lots of activities for the kids, the people were so nice, and there was a lake nearby. The only issue was that there was no sewage at the individual sites. So you have to close up the RV, drive to the dumping area, drain the tanks there, and then drive back to your spot. This isn't very convenient, so I'd recommend only staying at those campsites if necessary. The RV we chose had slide outs, which gave us some more space when we were parked. It also had air conditioning, heating, which were both useful on this trip because we started off our trip during a heat wave and ended it with fairly cool temperatures at night. One thing that really annoyed us during this trip was the flies. I don't know if this is something that always happens, but about halfway through our trip, we did have quite a few flies in the RV and it was impossible to get them all out. If you happen to know a solution for this issue, please let me know in the comments. All right, now let's get into the cost of an RV trip. To rent the RV that we chose, which was the second largest option, it was about $2,500 for the week. It's approximately $200 to fill up the tank each time, so we spent about $300 on gas since we got it with half a tank of gas. You have to return the RV with the same amount of gas that you received it with. It's approximately $100 per night to stay at the campsites. As for food, alcohol, wood, and ice, we probably spent around $500 for the week. So all in, you're looking at approximately $4,000 for 1 week. So it's not cheap, but if you have a fairly large family, buying plane tickets for everyone and flying somewhere for a vacation will cost a lot more. So it's actually not bad when compared to that type of a family vacation. That being said, this also isn't a relaxing vacation in paradise. It's a lot of work packing, cooking, and cleaning. You won't be coming back to a clean hotel room every night. You'll basically be responsible for doing everything. But it is an experience and the kids loved it. For now, Karen and I need a little break from RV trips, but we will definitely plan another one in the near future. Another thing to keep in mind is that you will have to return the RV fairly early in the morning. Otherwise, it's a hefty charge for not returning it on time. For us, we had to get it back by 10 a.m. So we actually couldn't make it home and unload, even though we left at 5:30 in the morning from our last destination. So what we ended up doing is driving straight to the RV drop-off place, and then we had to stuff everything into our car, plus our kids. It was super packed. We managed to get everything in and then drive home and unload. So make sure you keep that in mind when planning out your trip. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up and let me know that you'd like to see more videos like this one. And as I said earlier, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you're notified whenever I post a new video. You'll also want to check out one of these two videos for so much more content just like this. Thanks so much for watching my brand new series, Keeping Up with the Krishnamurthys. I hope to see you in the next episode.